Impossible is an interactive performance composition for three custom-made infrared sensors, Max and Kima. Impossible is a true virtuoso performance work that requires the rapid execution of thousands of notes within short time spans. Impossible is about musical speed and pounding action controlled through physical micro and macro movements. Through waves of musical intensifications, the interaction between performer and instrument drives the dramatic thrust of the composition. The title is a play on words that refers to the extreme technical difficulties of performing the piece, Impossible, and the idea that these impossible difficulties can be overcome. I'm possible.
Hi, my name is Leah Reed. I'm the composer of Reverie. The work is an acousmatic composition that leads the listener through an immersive fantasy centered around deconstructed music boxes. The work contains 8 sections that alternate between explorations of the music box's gears and chimes. In the work, the music box's sounds are pulled apart, exaggerated, expanded, and combined with other sounds whose timbres and textures are reminiscent of the original. As the piece unfolds, the textures increase in spectral and textural density, and the associations become more and more fantastical. Gears are transformed into zippers, coins, chainsaws, motorcycles, and fireworks, and the chimes morph into rainstorms, all sizes of bells, pianos, and more. I hope you enjoy the piece.
Hi, my name is Tim Johnson, and it's an honor to have my composition Steel Plan on the program today. Steel Plan is scored for lead steel pan, vibraphone, and fixed media electronic playback. The composition is something of a freely composed fantasy on ideas inspired by the sounds of metal. The electronics part was created algorithmically using a set of steel pan samples. The microtonal sound world of the electronics creates a shifting harmonic field for the steel pan and vibraphone to move through, with important moments of conjunction that articulate the form. Many thanks to steel pan player Dan Bretz and vibraphonist Anthony J. Houston for their lovely performance.
Hello, I'm Gyeongmi Choi. Thank you for joining today. The piece you will watch is my 3D animation that I use my own poetry and image that I created and music I wrote. This piece is dedicated to my father who passed away a couple of years ago. And this piece is a part of large animated song cycle that I wrote for him. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Chi Wang. Newton's third law of motion states that for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. In my composition, I'm trying to engage that idea use two of those game track controllers, where I can push, pull, and release each one of those retractable tethers. However, those tethers are not likely to stay at where I want it to be. Looks to me that those sounds have their own minds.
Thank you. Mies is a two-channel fixed-media composition bookended by the voice of the renowned modernist architect Ludwig Mies van der Rohe. The opening statement establishes the ground rules for the composition. The closing statement expresses my desire for its reception / perception by the listener. I hope you enjoy it, and thank you for your time.
So I would throw everything out that is not reasonable. Thank you.
want to be interesting. I want to be good.
In Desperate Times was composed in 2020 while I was in COVID isolation and only virtually connected to the world. During this quarantine, I watched George Floyd get murdered on TV and frontline Latinx citizenry disproportionately die executing essential services for others. Concurrently, America has experienced a surge in bigotry and violence towards Asians. In Desperate Times is a real-time performance composition for Kima, Max, simple computer vision, a Wacom tablet, and a Logitech webcam.
Hello, my name is Trevor Adams, and I'm a graduate composition student at CCPA. The piece that I'm presenting tonight is called Anna. Anna is an Inupiaq word that means grandmother. I was inspired to write this piece after I discovered an interview that my Anna gave back in 2005. In it, she recounts her experiences growing up and living in Kotzebue, Alaska, and the surrounding areas. I used the dialogue from this interview as the basis for the fixed media electronics portion of my composition. I then took recorded violin sounds and sounds from northwestern Arctic Alaska to create the texture that supports the voice in this. The solo violin part is meant to also support and blend in with the fixed media electronics portion of the piece. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
I was born at the camp in the fall time, September 27, 1919, right across from Kotzebue. That's where I was born. They always do the camping to try to get a, you know, games or anything for, to put away for the winter. And fishing, seal hunting, anything they can hunt. In the ocean too. And they always try to gather all that and put away in what we call those pokes. Seal pokes, they call them. I don't know what they in English. We don't have any name for the pokes. Seal pokes, we call them. It's a seal they woman, I'll have to take all that blubber out, and as long as you can reach, you do with a, they have a little knife, ulu. Big ulu, ulu, ulu. And after they do all that, Mom used to take all the blubber out. I learned to do that. Even me, I used to do that. And then you blow air in from your mouth, blow it in. And then when there's little holes, then you can tell. Then you sew those and make sure it won't leak. And after they do that, either with a soot, it's a brown, you know, when the woods are all burned, you put a little water in, you rub the skin, the whole skin, and dry it up. Make sure the bugs don't get into them, you really watch those. And then after you do that, when they dry them up, you cut them up in pieces and put them inside through the mouth, you know, that's where they put the blubber and everything in there.